The market is in a state of shock because of the emergence of a Chinese startup called DeepSeek, which has just introduced its new super-capable language model R1 that outperforms OpenAI's ChatGPT 01. But the question arises, how safe is it to use it? Is DeepSeek really sending your data back to China? Or is it okay to trust it with your personal information? How can you use it safely? Let's find out. DeepSeek R1, the chatbot with the blue whale logo. Before I tell you if it's okay to swim with this big blue whale, let me highlight a few key things about them. DeepSeek is a Chinese tech startup founded just a year ago. The language model, DeepSeek R1, seemingly came out of nowhere. As a matter of fact, it was developed in a fraction of the time and cost compared to its US competitors. Not only that, but as many have experienced, including myself, it is superior to established players like ChatGPT and Claude. The R1 model employs reinforcement learning techniques, making it well suited for complex reasoning tasks, particularly in applications that require logical problem solving and decision making. It is also remarkable that its development budget was pretty limited, just $5.6 million. This amount of money is insignificant when compared to the billions invested by firms such as OpenAI, Microsoft, and Google. This achievement is even more impressive when you consider that DeepSeek had to overcome significant challenges, including restrictions on access to the most advanced semiconductor chips due to the US trade embargoes. R1 has drawn the attention of developers worldwide. Unlike other LLMs, its open source nature allows users to customize it as they wish. This flexibility combined with its affordability have made it an attractive option. In fact, operating costs are reportedly up to 30 times lower than its US counterparts. For years, it was believed that breakthroughs in AI required vast resources, years of research, and access to advanced hardware. DeepSeek has shattered this notion, demonstrating that creativity can flourish even in challenging or constrained conditions. But it's not all sunshine and rainbows. A startup from China that uses your data? This naturally raises questions about data privacy, security, and yeah, global competition. Although DeepSeek's technological advancements have received considerable praise, its methods of data collection have raised significant concerns. Simply browse through Reddit or Facebook groups to see for yourself. But why does this happen? Just take a look at their privacy policy. The company openly admits to collecting and storing a wide range of user data, including chat histories, personal account details, IP addresses, payment information, and even keystroke patterns. This data is stored on servers located in the People's Republic of China, as explicitly stated in the company's FAQ. The implications of this practice are profound. Under China's personal information protection law, companies are required to provide data to the government upon request. Authorities can access this information under the excuse of national security, a provision that has fueled fears of state surveillance. Critics argue that this could lead to profiling individuals and organizations, exposing sensitive business data, and even enabling cyber surveillance campaigns. And let's be honest, the Chinese Communist Party aims for global dominance of some sort. This means it's almost certain that whatever data you feed into R1 will be shared and analyzed by the party's officials. Although technically advanced users can host the R1 model locally or through third-party services, this option remains inaccessible or unknown to most people. Data transmission to China is automatic and unavoidable for the average user accessing DeepSeek through its web interface or app. DeepSeek has also faced criticism for alleged censorship. Users on Reddit, Facebook, and other online forums have shared instances where R1 avoids politically sensitive topics. It's likely that this approach might indicate potential state influence. Just recall what happened a few weeks earlier with TikTok, another Chinese application that was accused of government oversight in shaping the narratives and information. Take a look what will happen if I ask it about the famous 1989 Tiananmen Square massacre in China. Now, I'll ask for a joke for President Trump. And then I'll ask for another joke for Xi Jinping, the President of the People's Republic of China. Naturally, this raises huge concerns about the ethical dimensions of DeepSeek R1. However, I can't help but admire how rapidly Chinese companies evolve and grow. DeepSeek's success underscores China's rapid progress in artificial intelligence. In my opinion, it's clear that we must reassess the technological and economic balance of power. Despite the privacy and security concerns, DeepSeek R1 remains an impressive chatbot with high capabilities and immense potential. But what if you want to take advantage of it without compromising your data? There are two safer alternatives. First, you can host the model locally or using third-party GPU services like Hyperbolic Labs. This way, you can eliminate the risk of data transmission to Chinese servers. This method allows users to fine-tune and deploy the model locally, keeping their data secure. Another approach for using DeepSeek R1 is my favorite one. It's through Perplexity. By hosting the model on servers located in the US, Perplexity ensures user data is protected under stricter privacy regulations. This is what you need to do. Go to perplexity.ai, activate the Pro button over here, and select the R1 option. This way, you can enjoy R1 safely within Perplexity. DeepSeek R1 represents a turning point in the AI industry. It is a testament to the power of innovation, achieving what was once thought impossible with limited resources. However, its rise also serves as a warning, showing the ethical and security issues that come with the technological advancements. So yeah, in my opinion, you should not use DeepSeek directly via their website or mobile application. Using it with the two alternatives I proposed earlier in the video is far more safer. One thing is crystal clear. No company will give out a service they work their butts off for free. There is nothing truly free. You always give something in return. If you want to know more about the so-called free AI tools out there, check the video shown on your screen. What are your thoughts on DeepSeek R1? Is it a technological marvel, a privacy nightmare, or both? Let me know in the comments below. Till the next time, see you.